Good morning. And many apologies for starting late. We've had a few technical issues with the PowerPoint presentation not loading or running very well. So we'll see if we can rectify that before the end of the service. Otherwise, this service will be a bit shorter. However, here we are, and lovely to see you all gathered in this morning at Cockpen, Carrington. Warm welcome to you, and a warm welcome for those who are watching later on the recording. You are also most welcome wherever you are watching from. Today, as many of us will be aware, is Christian Aid Sunday. For our service, we're going to use the materials that they've prepared for this year's appeal. It just gives us time to learn a bit more about their work and see their work. And this year, it's based on the situation in Burundi and one family there, a lady called Aline Nibagora, who we will hear from. Nibagora. Who we will hear from through our service. But that is our theme for today. Can I just also mention before we begin that just a thank you, first of all, to those of you who filled in the Growing Young questionnaire that was available to fill in at the end of last year. And a summary of the responses that came in has been very kindly prepared by Liz McDonald. So that is available to have a look at, and also on top of that, a bit of a follow-up after a recent Kirk session meeting in which we have put up a few actions that will hopefully be in place or coming into place on the back of the responses or some of the responses that came in. And that will be an ongoing thing as we look at that and see how we can build and build on those responses and following them up. But one of the things that was mentioned was improving communication in the church and keeping you better up to date with what's going on. And so there are now minutes of the Kirk session meeting available. There are four copies, hard copies of the minutes of the last meeting, which happened on the 17th of April. So copies of that are available down there. You can either sit after the service for a wee while and read them without taking them away, or there's a little sign-up sheet, and you can put your name saying that you're taking a copy away, so you can read it at home in your leisure, but then please bring it back next Sunday and then tick your name off that you've returned it. So that gives an opportunity to hopefully keep in touch and keep up to date with what's happening and decisions being made. The copies of the report, the Growing Young follow-up analysis of responses and follow-up is available for you to take away. So just help yourself to a copy if you'd like at the end of the service. So I don't think there are any other intimations this morning, except to say, please do stay at the end of the service if you're able, because a beautiful big brekkie for Christian Aid has been prepared by a wonderful team of ladies here, and gentlemen, surely shouldn't say just ladies, but anyway, a lovely big brekkie has been prepared, so please do stay if you're able and support that further this morning, and joining together in a lovely time of fellowship at the end of our service. But today we have, as I was saying, our Christian Aid service, and the theme this year that they've chosen is that of extraordinary love. And they're thinking about God's love for each of us that exceeds what we can imagine. And we're also called to live out that love in service to one another. And our guide leading us through our worship today is Aline Nibagora from Makamba province in Burundi. Married when she was still a child, Aline experienced domestic violence, homelessness, and extreme poverty. She was brought to a point where she says that people forgot I was human. But Arlene's love for her children and her experience of God's love filled her with exceptional courage. She was determined to give her children a better life and to help her neighbours. And so we'll continue to hear her story and the situation in Burundi as we go through our service. But we join, first of all, in our call to worship this morning that's based on part of John's expression of love in 1 John 3 and verse 1. And if you'd like to, please join in the parts marked in bold. We gather as children of God, bound to one another by love. See what love the Father has given us. We gather to live out our calling to love our neighbours and our enemies. See what love the Father has given us. We gather to experience in word and song, in prayer and worship, the overflowing compassion and tenderness of our God. See what love the Father has given us. And so we're going to join to sing our opening hymn this morning as we're thinking about God's love for us and our love for him flowing out to our love for each other. We begin with a hymn that celebrates that God's love for us through Jesus Christ, his Son. And we sing, O love, how deep, how broad, how high. Will now bring us part one of Arlene's story.
Burundi is one of the poorest countries in the world financially. More than 70% of the population live in poverty. Most people get their living through farming. Farmers have been significantly affected by the climate crisis, facing droughts, floods, and landslides. Many families eat just one meal a day. Philip Galgola, country director of Christian Aid Burundi, tells us, "I think the biggest worry for most Burundians' mothers is how they will feed their children." On top of all of this, Alina Nibagora faced an extra challenges. She was abused by her husband and forced out of her home, becoming separated from her children. With nowhere to live and worrying daily about her children's safety, Alina was pushed into the most extreme poverty.
And so we join in our opening prayer. Let's pray. And Aline told Christian Aid, "God comforts you through troubled times and gives you hope for a better future. God, our comforter, source of our hope, be present to us today. Unite us as we worship. Give us ears to hear the good news of your abundant, transformative love. Stir up in us a prophetic voice that we may proclaim the coming of your kingdom. Inspire in us the courage to serve you in word and deed, as together we build a world free from poverty. Creator God, you made us and cherish us as your beloved creation. We confess that we have failed to care for the world you brought into being. We have polluted the earth. We have consumed without thought for the future. We have hardened our hearts and turned away from communities devastated by the climate crisis. Out of the greatness of your love, Lord, forgive us. Jesus, you call us to love our neighbor, to go the extra mile. We confess that we have failed to love others as you love us. Too often we have ignored cries for justice. We have given our energies to protecting what is ours and have failed to consider the needs of others. Out of the greatness of your love, Lord, forgive us. And words of the prayer for Christian Aid Week 2024. Loving God, help us to hear the voices of those enduring extreme poverty. It is hard to listen to stories of pain. Show us how compassion for others can bring healing and fullness of life for all. Help us to understand that we are one through your love, for every human being is loved by you beyond measure. Loving God, you call on us to build your kingdom of justice, mercy, and truth. It isn't a task for the faint-hearted. When we lose our sense of purpose, fill us with faith. When we doubt or throw up our hands in despair, fill us with hope. When we pass by our neighbor as though we did not know them, fill us with a love that turns us back and takes us to their aid. In Jesus' name, we ask all these things and pray now in the words he taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And Elizabeth will bring part two of Aline's story now.
Alina told Christian Aid about life when she was homeless. I wandered the streets asking anyone for a place to sleep. Those who showed me kindness would let me stay for 2 or 3 days, but it was difficult. People would insult me and treat me with contempt. They forgot I was human. I was a human being. It filled me with sorrow. Aline never gave up. Pushed to the brink of survival, she pushed back. Aline joined a community workshop led by Christian Aid-funded trainers. She learned about village savings and loan associations and was determined to form her own to help herself and others around her. Village savings and loans associations offer a way for the community groups to manage, save and lend money. Aline was able to get a start-up loan and begin trading avocados and peanuts. She was also able to buy a bicycle so that she could transport her goods.
We're going to sing again, and just before we do, actually, I forgot to welcome Kenny to our service today while Graham is away, but thank you, Kenny, for being with us to play. It's lovely to welcome you. But we join to sing again, and our hymn is one that beautifully describes the immeasurable love of God. There's a wideness in God's mercy, like the wideness of the sea.
The reading is from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 13, verses 1 to 13. It's entitled Love. I may be able to speak the languages of human beings and even of angels, but if I have no love, my speech is no more than a noisy gong or a clanging bell. I may have the gift of inspired preaching, I may have all knowledge and understand all secrets, I may have all the faith needed to move mountains, but if I have no love, I am nothing. I may give away everything I have and even give up my body to be burnt, but if I have no love, this does me no good. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. Love is eternal. There are inspired messages, but they are temporary. There are gifts of speaking in strange tongues, but they will cease. There is knowledge, but it will pass. For our gifts of knowledge and of inspired messages are only partial. But when what is perfect comes, then what is partial will disappear. When I was a child, my speech, feelings, and thinking were all those of a child. Now that I'm grown up, I have no more use for childish ways. What we see now is like a dim image in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. What I know now is only partial. Then it will be complete as God's knowledge of me. Meanwhile, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Many families in Burundi struggle daily to meet their basic needs. Food and land are in short supply. Healthcare is out of reach for many. The cost of living is soaring. Livelihoods are under threat by droughts, floods, and landslides. People are pushed to the brink of survival. My name is Nibogora Aline. I am 35 years old. My favorite people in the whole world are my three sons. I enjoy a lot being with my family. We like traditions and we have a fixed time for praying. It is an opportunity to talk to God because we are still alive thanks to God's grace. We have gone through hardships because I was very poor as I was stuck inside a box. Through the support of Christian Aid and its partners, Aline and her neighbors were trained to form a village savings and loan association. They each pay in a small amount to build up a group fund and can loan to fund income generating activities. We have three savings groups in this community now. We work together to save and make loans. This has had a great impact on my life. I realized that women can achieve great things. I raise my children alone, I bring them up well, nobody is going hungry. I managed to buy goats, which helped me a lot, and I bought a bicycle.
Carrying goods to our home was difficult before getting a bicycle. We would carry 10 kilograms on our heads, but with a bicycle, be it 100 kilograms or 200 kilograms, you just tie it on and ride quickly. We use it for firewood and crops from the farm.
I have a solar panel. I can turn on the lights so that my children can do their homework. And I am building my own home. After finishing my house, I will continue to save with the association, because I really wish for my children to study in the university. They are my hope for the future. With your help, we can work towards a world where families can push back against the inhumanity of poverty and fulfill their ambitions. From community events to individual challenges, Christian Aid Week is 7 days of action, your way to fund lasting change. Together, we will beat extreme poverty.
Aline's business was successful, and she was able to rent a house. At last, she was reunited with her three eldest sons, who came to live with her. She is hopeful that one day she will be together with all of her children. Aline can now afford food for herself and her family. She has bought solar panels so that her children can have light to help them study. Now Aline is baking her own bricks and building a stronger house for her family, in every sense. Aline told Christian Aid, "We pray together as we are still alive thanks to God's grace. We have been through difficult times, but now we make plans for the future."
And so we're going to sing again. And a hymn that is one that expresses all that love can mean to us and reminds us constantly that God is where love is, for love is of God. So let's join to sing the hymn, "Love is a Touch of Intangible Joy."
Our second reading is taken from the Gospel of St. Mark. Mark 12, reading verses 28. The Great Commandment. A teacher of the law was there who heard the discussion. He saw that Jesus had given the Sadducees a good answer, so he came to him with a question. "Which commandment is the most important of all?" Jesus replied, The most important one is this: Listen, Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second most important commandment is this: Love your neighbor as you love yourself. There is no other commandment more important than these two. The teacher of the law said to Jesus, Well done, teacher. It is true, as you say, that only the Lord is God, and that there is no other God but He. And to love God with all your heart, and with all your mind, and with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself, is more important than to offer animals and other sacrifices to God. Jesus noticed how wise his answer was, and so he told him, You are not far from the kingdom of God. After this, nobody dared to ask Jesus any more questions. For the word of God in Scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us, we give thanks. Amen.
Thank you, John. As we're thinking about love this morning, we might ask the question, what is love? And we might all come out with different answers to that. But we can think about the many symbols of love that we have round about us, that we quite often use. Things perhaps the most common, little heart shape that so often now can be used at the end of our text messages. A little heart to express love. There's also that little cross that means a kiss, we might use at the end of letters if we're still letter writing to friends and loved ones, or that often still comes in on cards and text messages to express love as well. It might be in the symbol of a rose or the bunch of red roses that is sometimes given as an expression of love. And wedding rings. I conducted a wedding yesterday morning at Rosewell Church, and the couple again exchanged wedding rings. And it's a lovely picture of the love and the commitment that the couple share together. Or it might be in family photos that adorn the walls of our homes. And it's curious, though, that even when we have so many ways to represent love available to us, love is somehow bigger than all of them put together. Sometimes we encounter extraordinary stories of love persisting through the most challenging situations. And this Christian Aid Week, Alin Nibagora offers us one such story. Alin's love for her children and for her community is evident in all that she does. She has held on to faith, hope, and love, even when extreme poverty pushed her to the brink of survival. Aline's story gives us an insight into what love can mean. Perhaps love can be expressed in hearts and flowers, but it is also shown in the solar panels that give Aline's children light to complete their schoolwork, in the Village Savings and Loans Association, where community members support one another, in each brick of the home that Aline is building for her family, and in the meals she shares with her neighbours. In his letter to the Corinthians, Paul can't stop at one or two definitions of love. We hear that love is patient, kind, rejoices in the truth. Love means we persist, we hope, we believe. Love is endless, writes Paul. And in the final part of the reading, Paul is reaching for something that he acknowledges is inexpressible in this life. The fullness of love that we will find when we know God as God knows us. That passage is often chosen as a reading for weddings, and indeed I read part of it yesterday for the couple. It was one of the choices of reading for their wedding service. But Paul wasn't primarily writing about the love married couples share here, although the examples and the words he uses are so fitting for them as they embark on their married lives together. Paul was writing about the need for love in the church and the true qualities of selfless love, so exemplified by Jesus, that should shine out from any church fellowship if it is to honour God and be fruitful in all it is and does. Love isn't just cards, kisses, flowers, hugs, though it can be expressed through these things so wonderfully. Love is how we follow our calling as children of God. Love is our response to God, who first loved us with a love greater than we can ever imagine. Through God, love is the core of who we are. God's love transforms us. It gives us the strength to choose to love people living in poverty who we've never met, and the empathy to create change for good. Love is our response to one another, recognizing we are all God's children and equally cherished by Him. Love calls us to stand together and seek each other's dignity, equality, and justice. That's why love is one of Christian Aid's core values and its motivation. It drives the team to stand in solidarity with global neighbours against poverty and injustice. It moves them to strive for a world where everyone has fullness of life. It sustains them with energy and passion as they commit to working alongside global neighbours worldwide. Aline told Christian Aid, here in Burundi, a neighbour is considered a member of the family. And that's a wonderful picture to hold. And we can see how Aline lives out love of neighbour as a daily reality. She helps, supports her neighbours just as she does members of her own family. Our love of neighbour follows from the love we receive from God and that we offer God. And we each have the joy and privilege to play our part as neighbours in joining today and through this Christian Aid Week in bringing our gifts to be shared out in the work of Christian Aid and all it's doing across the world against poverty and injustice. We can play our part to make a real difference in bringing love and hope to others in need. Our next hymn is a song prepared by Christian Aid, focusing on its work, a lovely song called A Song of the Kingdom, and it expresses something of how we can be a voice together. We each have a voice to speak out and sing out together, and we have impact as we do that together and love and share love across communities in our world and make a difference for good together, sharing God's love out where there is need.
I have a voice, you have a voice, we have a voice, and when we sing together, a line is drawn, and hope reborn. This is the song of kingdom come.
I have a voice, you have a voice, we have a voice. When we sing together, a line is drawn, and hope reborn. This is the song of kingdom come. We heard the cries of distant neighbors, the dispossessed, the refugee, and God.
command to feed the hungry and set them free, and set them free. We heard the word, the new commandment, and we reclaimed the prophet's call. Love the world without condition, God's love for all, God's love for all. I have a voice, you have a voice, we have a voice when we sing together. The line is drawn and hope reborn. This is the song, the song of kingdom come. A reckless love that knows no borders, that speaks the truth to those in power, that shines a light on cool indifference. This is God's hour, this is God's hour, when we will stand against injustice. All who live against the grain, until their poverty is over, and love shall reign, I have a voice, you have a voice, we have a voice, when we sing together, the line is drawn. Song of kingdom come. We won't stand by while sisters suffer, nor turn blind eyes to ruthless wrong. Our song of praise will be compassion, this kingdom song, this kingdom song. A song of love and liberation, lasting peace, a taste of life in all its fullness. God's masterpiece, God's masterpiece.
I have a voice, you have a voice, we have a voice, when we sing together.
A line is drawn and hope reborn. This is the song, song of kingdom come. I have a voice, you have a voice, we have a voice, when we sing together. The line is drawn, and hope reborn. This is the song, song of kingdom come.
We're going to continue now with our offering as we worship God together.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you have abundantly blessed us. Your mercy knows no bounds. We bring these offerings for the work of your church and commit ourselves to action, following your command to love one another. Today also, as we give thanks for the vital work of Christian Aid and for all who support this work, may the gifts we bring for their work transform the prospects of those living in extreme poverty. May your extraordinary love radiate through our words and actions every day of our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And Elizabeth will bring us part four and the concluding part of Aline's story now.
Burundi continues to be one of the toughest places on earth to live, and Aline and her family still face challenges. When a ferocious storm destroyed Aline's house, almost killing her and her children, she was able to recover by selling the cows she'd been keeping. Now, when crisis threatens her family's survival, Aline has options. Even a small business can provide just enough resilience to weather the most brutal of storms in Burundi. Aline's now the chairperson of the Village Savings and Loan Association that she founded. She is using her experience to help transform the lives of 25 families who are building their own, a brighter future together. Aline says, if anyone has a problem, we help them find a solution. The members thank me for the training and the positive impact it has had on their daily lives. People come to me as they trust me. Here in Burundi, a neighbour is considered a member of the family.
And with all of those different parts of the story in mind, we join our hearts in prayer, joining in our prayers of thanksgiving and our prayers for others and ourselves. Let us pray. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. God, we are thankful for your love. Love that changes us, turns our priorities upside down, and yet somehow makes us more fully ourselves. We offer our gratitude for those who have shown us tenderness, care, and compassion. Those who have seen us through troubled times and brought us hope. We pray for those we love and for those we've failed to love. Remembering Aline's experience, we hold in mind people around the world who know what it is to be treated as less than human. May we work together to uphold the dignity of every human being so that no one feels forgotten. Dear Lord, we are thankful for those who inspire us with their strength, courage, and perseverance. We pray for people around the world brought to the brink by extreme poverty, struggling to survive. We pray especially for families in Burundi who do not have sufficient food, clean water, or access to health care. Fuel us with fire of your spirit. Fill us with a fierce determination to end the outrage of poverty. May we hear the cries of those who are excluded from power. May we speak up with them for a more equal and just world. Loving God, we are thankful for peacemakers and healers. We pray for all those who are reaching across divisions and acting to end violent conflict. May political leaders use their power wisely to further the cause of peace. And we pray especially for peace in the Middle East, an end to the war in Ukraine, for those affected by conflict in Sudan, and for ongoing peacemaking work in Burundi. We remember with sorrow the lives lost in conflict. Loving God, we are thankful for love in action. And we give thanks for the cake bakers, the runners, the envelope collectors. We are grateful for those who give their time, energy, and resources to sponsored walks, craft sales, cycles, swims, and to all kinds of fundraising challenges for Christian aid this week. And thank you for those who have prepared the big brekkie for us today here at church. We pray that each of us may recognize the gifts we have to share and that we may see too the richness of our neighbor's gifts and talents. Help us to be a part of making possible the joyful living that you desire for each of us. May we all be free to live life joyfully in all its fullness. Gracious God, we're thankful that you offer comfort to us in our sorrows. We give thanks that when everything else around us seems to crumble, you promise us that your love will remain solid and steadfast. Thinking of all that Aline has been through, we pray for her, her children, and her community. And we pray for others known to us who are suffering, whether through ill health, through financial cares and concerns, through concerns of work, revision and exams, through family concerns. And we pray for those who have lost someone they love. May they each one know your peace and comfort and your presence with them. We offer these prayers in Jesus' name. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Amen. Do stay, if you're able, at the end of the service to join in the big brekkie and share fellowship together. And now, though, we want to sing our closing hymn this morning, which is one that helps us think about rejoicing in the restoring love of God that we receive and pass on in our lives and in our world. We join to sing, Children of God, Reach Out to One Another.
Thank you.
May we persevere in faith. May we go out in hope. May we act and speak with love by the grace of God. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all and remain with you now and evermore.